Let them scream, let them cry. That's why it doesn't bother me. That's why I'm so happy to see them screaming and crying. Let them cry. When the enemy is screaming and wailing, that means that we are safe and the enemy is getting destroyed, Hashem promised. I love it. I love these demonstrations. I enjoy them. It, to me, I just get out the popcorn and let's enjoy.
Ladies and gentlemen, Rabbi Tovia Singer. Rabbi, Shalom Aleichem, Salam Aleikum. How are you?
Aleikum Salam, Aleichem Shalom. It's so nice to be with you,
Doctor. Screaming and crying, good. Baruch Hashem, they should keep screaming and crying, and the wail shouldn't stop. I'm such a joy. I can't wait for the next demonstration where they're crying and screaming. It's a picnic.
Please do subscribe to the Rabbi's channel. I know that I have been for a very long time, and most people watching here will be as well. And I do look forward to doing future content with the Rabbi.
Rejoicing, that means Jews are dead. So I let them scream, let them cry. That's why it doesn't bother me. That's why I'm so happy to see them screaming and crying. God help us. God help us if they're laughing. If they're you know when they laugh in Gaza, you know when the last time they rejoiced? When 3,000 Americans were murdered on 9/11. They were passing out candy. That's what makes them laugh. That's what makes them rejoice. You know when they rejoice? When an Israeli soldier's body was kidnapped, they were rejoicing all over. When did they rejoice? When 5 soldiers were murdered. Let them cry. When the enemy is screaming and wailing, that means that we are safe and the enemy is getting destroyed, Hashem promised. I love it. I love these demonstrations. I enjoy them. It, to me, I just get out the popcorn and let's enjoy. What do you want? You want the pro-Hamas people? I'm accusing the word people very loosely here. Do you want these pro-Hamas, this Edom, to be rejoicing, to be smiling? No, I want them to be crying.
It's an optimistic way of looking at it.
It's really not a twist on anything. I remember going back, I'm sure you remember, 15 years ago when the suicide bombings were going off, we were having demonstrations on the streets with 100,000 pro-Israel people screaming and crying. Let them scream and cry. That means our children are alive. When the 3 boys were murdered, those 3 children were murdered, which launched all this, and in a way, they're karbonos, they are sacrifices in a sense, they're really, it's a real Mashiach Ben Yosef moment. What happened when those 3 boys were executed? The Arabs are so happy that these boys were executed, and that's what makes them happy. If they're screaming and crying, good, Baruch Hashem, they should keep screaming and crying, and their wail shouldn't stop. I'm such a joy. I can't wait for the next demonstration where they're crying and screaming. It's a picnic.
It's a picnic.
It is. It means that we're alive. It is. It's true. It's true.
It's good. I'm glad. I feel a lot better having talked to you about it. It's good.
Really?
Yeah.
I love that.
I'm not upset. I'm happy. Thank God. That means that the enemy is going down and they're crying and wailing because the heroes are going up in being vaporized. I'm feeling great. Okay. I'm feeling terrific. Okay. I'm feeling good. But I just got an email from a very nice Christian. He says, I'm a Christian, I love Israel, but they're screaming and shouting in the streets of London, he writes to me. I said, thank God they're screaming and crying in the streets of London. Could you imagine if they were rejoicing? What would that mean? That would mean our soldiers are being murdered and slaughtered. So it's so obvious. This requires, but you know, we're very nervous about what people think of us. You know, we're not seeking out the approval of the world. This is the enemy. Let them scream. Let them wail. I hope they're screaming and wailing tomorrow. God help us if they're rejoicing in the streets of London. God help us if they're rejoicing in the streets of Damascus. God help us if they're screaming and dancing in Gaza City. Let them scream and wail, and that means our boys are alive and the terrorists are going to their rightful reward.
So what about the people that look at the demonstrations in all the major cities around the world, and the Palestinians and the pro-Palestinian demonstrations, so on and so forth, reminiscent of Nazi Germany? What of that?
What do you mean reminiscent of Nazi Germany? They're idiots. That means this. If someone is in North Korea, I don't blame them. Why? Because in North Korea, they don't have access to the internet. They don't have access to Fox News. They don't have access to Fox News, to Sky News. So all they're doing is they're getting their brainwashed, bombarded with one ideology. So I understand that. But today, there's very little excuse for a person in the Western world who can go easily go on the internet, read both sides, and make an informed decision. These are enemies of the Jewish people, and they have access. They have free will now. There's no excuse anymore for someone to say, I was ignorant, I didn't know. They can hear both sides. They don't want to. Yeah, of course, if they take out crazy glue and they glue their channel to Al Jazeera, yeah, of course, that's what you get. But they're a bunch of idiots if they do that. Today, there's an information explosion. Any idiot could have a balanced information and make an informed decision. And look at Canada. Canada also has the Toronto Star, a filthy anti-Israel rag, but they also have the National Post. So they have information on both sides. And Canadians, thank God, they have a great prime minister and so on. People can make an informed decision today. That's all. The information is available. I let them scream and cry. If I catch them stopping to scream and cry, I'm going to be very upset.
Please do subscribe to the Rabbi's channel. I know that I have been for a very long time, and most people watching here will be as well. And I do look forward to doing future content with the Rabbi.